Hello, internet friends. My name is Bay. This is Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, but I'm bad, a light commentary playthrough where I play the entire game in the course of chunks or live if you'd like. You just got to chapter two. You just got to chapter two. Talking is hard sometimes when you don't do it all the time. Let's see what happens. This is all going to be new now.
A gift from our humble establishment. Though it may not look like much, it should help you to break the ice with those you meet.
Queen's blood?
Oh my. So, one of the things I know about Seven Rebirth is there are lots of minigames, and Queen's Blood is essentially Final Fantasy Gwent. Not like how you play it, but you know how there was Fort Condor in Episode Intermission with Yuffie, which I guess is also in this game apparently too. So there's lots of side quests and there's lots of mini games. Some of them I probably won't like the piano one. So the fleeting players also gives you opportunity to fight other opponents in different towns. Same thing as Fort Condor. Oop. Sure. So I watched how to play this. Placing cards that you can and buffing your lanes. Cards only place in positions equal to or higher than their rank, which is denoted by the number of pawns in the top left corner of the card. Yeah. Okay, so once both sides pass, the game's over. That's a You gonna win? You have to win two lanes? Oh, it's just total score. Final Fantasy Gwent, here we go. Will we be doing all of it? Yes. Will we try to collect every single card? Yes. Will we do every single side quest in this game, at least the ones that we are given because of the branching options? Yes. So over the top. Okay. Got the doodads. The technological juxtapositions in the Final Fantasy VII world are kind of funny sometimes.
Of course, this is only the most recent in a series of crises. Multiple reactor bombings, followed by the fall of the Sector 7 plate, culminating in this unprecedented destruction. Caused by a massive tornado which swept through sectors 0, 1, and 2. After a briefing with Shinra investigators, Mayor Domino released a statement declaring the tornado to be, quote, weather warfare, perpetrated by the infamous insurgent group known as Avalanche. The administration also suspects the involvement of Wutai and has begun investigations into the matter.
Good morning, sir. I must apologize for not introducing myself to you earlier. I'm Broden, the owner of this inn. Your companions have all stepped out. Oh, but Barrett left a message he wanted me to pass along to you. You missed roll call, soldier boy. Luckily, you're on leave for the day. Don't waste it, though. Get your equipment checked ASAP. Sound advice. Perhaps a trip to the arms dealer is in order?
Good idea.
By the way, Cloud, do you have any folios on you?
Yeah.
What?
In that case, you might also want to pay a visit to Magnata Books. They have stores all over, but the first official one was built here in Calm. And their resident scholars are remarkably talented. If you want to unlock the true potential of your folios, you should go see them. The first customization is always free. Calm's a simple but beautiful town.
The heck is a folio? Oh goodness. I'm trying to see if it was like a card list of how many. There is not.
I need to keep this place looking spick and span. Don't want to let Broden down. Especially after he insisted I focus exclusively on cleaning.
Hmm. Of course. This is only the most recent in a series of crises. Multiple reactor bombings.
Finally. Rough day yesterday, huh? You've been waiting for me? I've been waiting for a chance to thank you properly. Without your help, I'd still be in Hojo's clutches, trapped in that lab. Was nothing. Even so, I owe you a debt. Until it's paid, I'm going to accompany you.
RDXP?
If you're getting your equipment checked, have them check mine while you're at it. Sure thing. The Rook's got a backbone.
Party level. I wonder if there are pros and cons to doing either. Do you always need party level? Do you not always need party level? Okay. It seems like it's the more skills and abilities you'll be available in your folios. How many more? Goodness. Okay. That was a lot. Oh, you see the reward you get. Oh. See. Lose, I think. Barely? Yep. Like the phrase when you start, the whole draw blood. Because you're drawing cards, but it's called Queen's Blood. Well, I went, okay, I'm getting it. Kind of cheeky. Yeah, yeah. That's gross. You can totally lock the opponent out.
Nothing like a game of Queen's Blood to relieve some stress.
Speaking of, you look like you've got a lot weighing you down, too. It's written all over your face. Trust me, crying does wonders. You really ought to try it.
Oh, no. I get it. No one...
Oh, my goodness. It's a little much.
Yes, the chair's physics.
It took me long enough, but I finally went and got myself a cat. He's so cute. My camera roll's filling up.
I feel that. I'm the same way with my dog. I just gotta snap a pic of everything he does.
I know, right? I swear I have like a million photos of Cacti.
Wanna see him? I'm telling you, she's adorable.
Cacti.
You get your hands on a cat?
You know why Rufus had to step up, don't you? Everyone's saying it's because his dad caught
Morning.
Morning.
Everyone's kind of off doing their own thing.
I noticed.
Say, this tank remind you of anything?
Looks kind of like the water tower in Nibelheim.
Right? weird to think how much it meant to me back then, when I was still there.
Oh, goodness. They can alter portions of their story? Oh, man. So how much if you did like all positive and then all negative? And then what if some are positive and some are negative? Okay. That could be a lot.
This is such a quiet, peaceful town.
So this game is really making you... You're probably really playing as Cloud more than well, you were in the first one, but... Okay. It said press L1 to, like, see people's... A synergy skill for the first time with Cloud will improve his relationship with the corresponding teammate.
Feels a little weird to be taking it easy, though.
She's late. Too late. Or am I here too early? Was getting here a day ahead of time overkill? Maybe I got a little carried away with this whole proposal business, but the weekly horoscope was crystal clear. Preparation is key.
I want to go up the clock tower next. You can see Midgar from there. I gotta check to make sure sectors 2 and 3 are all right.
There's a nice breeze today.
Reactors are terrible.
Twister like that has, I could kiss my house goodbye.
This is a lot of town.
The scent of flowers and the wind is simply divine.
But what you do?
You can swim. Okay. I was not expecting that.
At it all day.
Excuse me. That was my barricade you just destroyed. Oh, come to admire the Bailey? It is something. Or maybe You're here to get your ass handed to you in a QB match. I'm Zahira. A pleasure. Just like Calm's wall, I yield to no one, refusing to give a single inch to my opponents. Don't presume you'll emerge unscathed if you decide to go up against me. Because you will wind up with more than just a few bruises.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Yikes. Can't leave the middle because I just okay. Thank you. There we go. Total victory.
Impossible. How could someone break through my perfect defense? Who are you? Deep down, I always knew. I knew I couldn't stay holed up in here forever. Walls can keep people safe. But even the sturdiest ones eventually crumble. Right. Starting today, you will be my new wall, as it were. And I am going to enjoy watching you crumble.
Oh my god.
You know, I thought Calm was some pit town in the middle of nowhere.
Technology sure has come a long
way. So aggressive.
Aha, finally decided to get up?
Yeah. So what you been doing?
Why, waiting for you, of course.
You have?
Got business with the bookstore? If so, I won't keep you. But if you're free afterwards, wanna climb the clock tower together?
Sure. Let's.
For real? Awesome! Since it was my idea, I'll go get the tickets. I'll meet you in front of the tower, okay? I'll catch up with you later, all right?
My one question is, are we gonna get D&D-esque Baldur's Gate 3 style? If you relationship up with certain characters, will it lower others? I'm assuming no. Or are there limits where you can only get so much with each and you have to, I don't know.
Hey there, welcome to Magnata Books. Oh, I take it this is your first visit to one of our stores. Well, customization can seem tricky to the uninitiated. It takes time and experience to get it right. But I think you'll pick it up quick enough. Let's give it a try.
Here we go. The augmenting folios. This is the new, like, crystal grid. You have to do it at book locations and automats. Not something you actually do in the field. So can you get everything or not everything? Probably not everything in a normal game playthrough and everything in a hard mode? I mean, how does doing the relationship stuff in hard mode, you have to do it all over again? Wouldn't that get annoying? Party level creates more skill cores. Character will earn SP when they level up or when they acquire manuscripts such as the Art of Swordplay, which will be a big part of hard mode. Unlocked skill cores can be reset at any time, and the SP spent will be returned, so feel free to experiment with different combinations.
And that's about all we can do for now. But we haven't even skimmed the surface, believe you me. There's much more to this than meets the eye. It may not seem like it yet, but you'll see. Hey there!
My goodness. Okay. Was a lot. Strange icon. It looks like two pieces of chicken, but it's like two arms like doing this, and they're interconnected. Like you're, I can't do it because my arm can't go that way. Just also keep in mind, only have 5 characters right now. We're missing Yuffie, Kate Sip, Vincent, and Sid. And they're all gonna have books too.
Thanks for stopping by.
Judging from that outfit, the manager is really into planetology.
I wonder if this crazy weather had anything to do with it.
All my vegetables are locally sourced. Don't pass up these succulent fruits straight from the orchard.
You won't find any meat cheaper than mine. See for yourself.
Come grab a sandwich before they're all...
Hello, and welcome to my humble shop.
Hi. I like your hair.
Come on over and see what we can do.
you again soon.
You won't find any meat cheaper than mine.
Fresh bread, straight from the oven. We've got plenty of sandwiches. Well, go on.
What are you looking for today? Come on over and see what we've got.
Such a change of pace from Midgar and Shinra Tower.
Sector 7 plate, culminating in this unprecedented destruction caused by a massive tornado which swept through Sector 0, 1,
Heading 01 brings
after
up
a briefing with Shinra investigators, menu. Mayor Domino released a statement declaring the tornado to be...
Look who it is. You up already?
Drinking already?
Ha, no, sir. Not gonna have a drop till 7th Heaven's back up and running.
Time soon, then.
Well, sooner than you think.
Multiple reactor bombings, followed by the fall of the...
Got a long road ahead of us. Better make sure you're prepped for the journey.
I feel like what I said there was negative, but it wasn't meant to be negative.
You're around here, I take it?
Domino released a statement, declaring the tornado to be, quote, weather warfare. Perpetrated by the infamous insurgents.
Want a drink? A little early, but we got an excuse.
I'll take a morning pizza, please.
Don't go buying any souvenirs, you hear? They'll just weigh us down.
Oops. I just spent 1,000 gil on trading on Magic the Gathering cards.
This is such a quiet, peaceful town.
I love how time almost seems to stop here.
Just thinking about what might have happened.
Birdie told me you can't get enough of that card game, Queen Slug.
Yeah, it's true.
All right, how's about we give these two-bit chumps a whooping? Boom! Looky here. I'd say we got ourselves a contender. So how about it, pretty boy? You want to throw down? But first, let me introduce you to Nene, Master Ventriloquist. Now, she ain't much of a talker, but give her a deck of cards, and she'll wipe the floor with you so fast, it'll make your head spin. Ready to get your ass handed to you? Well, are ya?
She's holding a Cuddlesworth. They're bombs. Feels like you want your half of your deck to be ones. You know, like 30% twos and 20% threes, kind of a deal. Because you don't have ones, you just don't get to cast, you don't get to play anything. We could take out one of the elephants out, huh? Then I'll work. Did that not work? Oh, it's too low. Needs to be played middle or top row. I see. Screwed here. I have enough cards to like set up. It feels like. Much learning. Shall be done. Thank you. Oh, they have to be connected. I see. Spicy. Oops, I
didn't. Wow, how do you like them apples? She might be small, but she's got power where it counts. Huh. Just so you know, Nene and her cards are ready for a game. If you got the guts.
It's gonna be a bit of a learning curve for sure. Only one blank space. Is that a loss again? Seems like pushing mid is super strong. This is hard. Okay. It's a lot of math and geometry.
But hey, you can't win them all. Besides, what really matters is who are brave enough to take on a bona fide card shark like Pretty Boy here. Sometimes you gotta take the L if you're serious about upping your game. Listen, kid, you got what it takes to be a champ. I bet my bottom gill on it. Now why don't you show Blondie your appreciation for being such a good sport?
Thank you for playing cards with me, mister.
This kid might need therapy.
Pretty Boy couldn't stay away, I see. If you're here to... Oh, what's the matter? Yes.
Or she might need a friend that's not a talking bomb.
I am Baron Kylegate. Behold the towering wall that I have built. The future of Calm is bright indeed.
No, no, that won't do at all. We'll never draw the crowds to the field.
Oh my god! It won't affect the Mako pipeline, will it?
My boy and I had a big falling out.
Headband. The thing is, when you're in the open world, everyone is still in your party. They're all roaming with you. And when you go into combat, the ones that aren't in your party, three man, are still around the battlefield. So I wonder if that still counts as them being for open world stuff, like with this. I don't know how that works, though. Just picturing Red with the headband on. So with the skill point stuff being only at certain places, it kind of limits when you can do it compared to...
How about a slice of Calm's mystery pizza? Just one bite and you'll find yourself running back for more.
All my vegetables are locally sourced. Don't pass up these succulent fruits.
Please. I am
I didn't find red.
Behold the towering wall that I
Excuse
have
me.
Built. The future of Calm.
The actors are terrible. That weirdo is whispering sweet.
Something for the kids? How about a handmade wooden doll?
Okay. Get my bearings. A lot of stuff, a lot of calm going around.
It's not open yet. If you got anything else you need to do, now's the time.
Oh.
It's so tall! I want to draw a picture of Midgar. Come on!
Welcome. Damn, that is quite the weapon you got there, mister. Seen plenty of action by the look of it. But saying that, it's still only a shadow of what it could be. With a little love, that baby'll sing. If you like, I could show you.
Wait, there's folios and weapon upgrades? Oh my god. Shinji Kirito's weapon will not reset this level. Oh, upgrade weapons can be done whenever. It's a totally different system, kinda. So same system before, but not. So you get so many and you just, okay. It's like weapon materia. Even though materia goes in weapons. You can also tweak your skill loadout by going to the materia and equipment screen, selecting a character. Yeah, of course.
She's got the voice of an angel. Just make sure you take proper care of her, all right? Oh, and while you're here, check out what we got to offer.
Mm-hmm. Oh. The cyberpunk system. I got no gill. I haven't gotten to crafting yet.
You take care of that weapon now.
Let's get started then, shall we?
Woohoo! It's not a race, Aerith. She wins.
I think Midgar's this away.
Should be, yeah.
Oh.
Funny, isn't it? How small it looks.
It is far away.
So, did something happen between you and Tifa?
Hmm?
Don't look so shocked. We're roommates, you know.
She say something?
Not about you two, no. Still, I can tell. I would have given anything to have a friend when I was growing up. Don't take her for granted.
Gotta be.
There you are. There isn't much time. We need to get back to the inn.
But...
Don't worry about your friends. They're safe. Trust me. No violence, please. This town suffered enough. Follow me.
Mm-hmm.
Not
take the back road.
Hey, you! Seen anyone acting suspicious?
I heard about the reactor bombings in Midgard. That was you, wasn't it? It's okay, I'm on your side. Got a contact at HQ.
You were with Avalanche?
Not exactly.
Stop.
I'll keep the troopers occupied. While we're talking, you two go up and over.
Yet?
No, but we're still searching buildings.
Well, search harder. We gotta find them.
That went well. The inn's not much further, but stay on your toes. Down below, waiting for you. The tunnel in the basement will take you outside of town. Leave now, and they won't catch you. Head to the east. A friend of mine runs a farm out there. He'd be happy to help you. Also, take this. It's a transmuter. Converts raw materials into more practical items. A Republic antique, but it still works.
Hmm.
You'll get more use out of it than me.
Why are you doing this? Could have just turned us in.
Yeah, I could have. But this town and I have a history with Shinra. Who knows? Maybe this will turn out to be the worst decision I've ever made. So before I change my mind, you better get going.
Mm. Yep. Transmuting, not crafting. Even though arose by any other name, still arose. I am assuming our ultimate weapons are gonna require some crazy transmuting, which will only be from certain enemies locations.
Oh, you made it. All in one piece? Sorry we're late.
For the love of, where the hell have you two been?
On a date, kind of. What?
Well, that was the last one. At least till things calm down. Got that? Now, let's move.
That was good. That was very good. The Naki's little head nod. Barret has definitely got bad energy, obviously.
Where to now?
Where there's a draft. This way.
Looks like a job for me.
I'm just gonna leave this loot right here. This is.
Wow. Just look at it all. It's so green. To it, it's still going strong.
It may look that way, but in reality, it's barely hanging on.
Guess I still have a lot to learn.
What do you want to know?
For starters, how do we cross these plains?
Come on now, that's easy. The same way you get anywhere. Pick a direction and start walking. Left, your left, your left, right.
I guess we won't be coming back anytime soon.
Guess not. Let's go.
And there it was, the first step on our new journey. You coming?
Yeah.
Of course we are. Right?
Follow me.
All right, let's get this show on the road, people.
Crazy. Okay, the little sprig is the world. The bone is dropped by enemies. Golden sprig, hard to come by. It's also transmuting from enemies, turning them into the material, and stealing and mugging as well. We're in for quite the ride. Thank you for watching if you're hanging out live. Of course, you can watch live if you'd like to. Links down below if you're watching on YouTube. Thank you for watching and hanging out. I think for the little bit of the start, the video chunks probably be closer to an hour and a half long, and then they'll go back to about an hour, I imagine. It's going to be a lot of game. A lot of game. Looking forward to it. If you want to watch Remake, of course, or the previous game's DLC and all that story stuff, also all on the channel, all in chunks, as well as previous playlists and playthroughs like Dark Souls and Elden Ring and Bloodborne and God of War and Super Mario RPG, a whole bunch of other stuff. Thanks for watching again. I'll see you in the next one.